Hey loves, it's Adanna here and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, I'm going to take you guys through how I get my nails done at home. You know, thanks to quarantine, it's actually my birthday nails and I wanted to do something a little bit fancy but like nude-ish kind of color. This is my third attempt at doing this, so I feel like I've gotten a little bit better than the last time I tried. If I can do this, you all can honestly do this, okay? And now, starting off with my natural nails, I went ahead to apply some alcohol just so I can dehydrate the nails and also take out like any oil or any form of like, you know, debris that's on my nail. That way, that's going to allow this false nail to actually stick on properly. Right now, I'm grabbing these false nails. I went ahead to use my drill just to roughen inside of the edge where I'm going to be sticking that down to my natural nail. In that way, it makes it a little bit rough, and when it's rough, it sticks on your natural nail a lot better and it just stays in place. And then I went ahead to apply some of the nail glue right there and I just stuck that right on my nail. If you don't have a nail drill, you can actually go ahead to use like a little nail file and just roughen it in there a little bit, and then it does the exact same job as well. So if you don't have a nail drill, it's totally fine. Also, these nail tips actually have a line that shows like a clear visual presentation of like, okay, this is where I should place this right on my natural nail. That definitely does help. And I also love the fact that these nail tips come pre-shaped into like this coffin shape, as you guys can tell. It makes my filing work a lot easier and it just makes the filing time a lot less. I got these nail tips from AliExpress. It took quite a while to arrive. I think it took about 1.5 months. And right now I'm just going to go ahead to use this nail clipper to cut these nail tips up to the length that I would like. I was also going for a coffin shaped nail, so I wasn't really going to have to do any much filing. I just sort of cleaned up the edge, made sure that everything is aligned properly with my natural nails, and you know, roughened the surface of this nail as well, just so it's easier for like the gel to stay on. Because you know, I'm not really a nail tech, but my friend who's a nail tech told me that if you roughen the top of the nail before putting any gel, it allows it to stay on longer and it just stays perfectly. Right now, that is all done. The filing is all completed, and right now I'm just using my buffer to clean up like any nail particles that's on the side or the corners. Moving on to like the entire gel application, I'm just going to start off using the IBD LED UV pH bonder. So I just applied this right there on my nail. So this is going to help my gel, my builder gel that I'm going to put after this, to stay on longer, and everything just stays perfectly in place for as long as I would love. So now I'm done putting on that pH bond, I'm just going to go ahead to cure this inside this LED lamp, and I cured for 60 seconds. And right now, moving over to the IBD builder gel, and I'm using this brush I got from Amazon as well, and I'll just build this gel onto my nails. I did the entire gel building about 3 times. So after the first application of this gel to build it onto my nails, I cured for 60 seconds and then took it out, belt it again, and then put it in and cured again for another 60 seconds, and then repeated the exact same procedure one more time. Honestly, you guys, I find this so satisfying to just sit down and just do my nails. It feels so good. A good way to save money and also proper hygiene. You're making sure that, you know, all your equipment are clean and it's only you that's using it. So, and I feel like I've been learning so much more as I kept doing this. This is my third attempt at doing my nails for myself. So I feel like I've learned a lot compared to the very first time that I did it. I've improved, I think. I don't know. You guys should let me know. The one that I'm still yet to try is acrylic nails. I've never tried acrylic before myself. My friend who's a nail tech was the one that actually advised me to start off with gel polish, just because it's a lot easier for like beginners and there's not so much filing to do, and also a lot of like, you know, all those acrylic mixture and stuff. I don't really know how to do that one yet, but I think I would like to learn. We'll see how that goes. So right now, I'm just going ahead to apply like the second coat of this gel onto my nails, and I'll just go ahead to cure this, and then we'll be right back to continue.
Me island team,
So I'm basically done building this entire gel onto my nails. I'll just go ahead right now to file these nails and just kind of like shaping it up a little bit, because that gel actually moves, like the builder gel, it moves quite a lot. So sometimes it makes your coffin shape to just go out of coffin to something else. So right now this is the time for me to like file to make sure that, you know, the coffin shape is still maintained and everything is still looking all, you know, slick. And I'm just filing. This part, like I said, it didn't take long at all because the nails already came pre-shaped compared to like the last time when I used like the, you know, the square nail. I had to do a lot of filing, but for this, it was just little to no filing. You could get away with this if your gel doesn't move that much, but mine does move, so that's why I'm filing right now. Anyway, you all should let me know down below in the comment section, have you ever tried doing your nails by yourself? Has quarantine made you to try so many things that you never thought you would try? I really want to know. So now moving on to the entire polish, I'm going to start off with my base coat. So this serves as a layer for your nail polish color to sit on, and it makes the entire polish to also last a lot longer. And I'm just going to apply this onto my entire nail. I just did one layer of this and cured it for 60 seconds as well, and it was just perfectly okay. And then I went ahead to use this Ameli nail polish that I got from Amazon. It's in the color 107. It's kind of like a nudish pink brownie nail polish. I just felt like it was perfect for like the entire vibe I was trying to achieve. Nothing too loud, nothing too bright. I just wanted something like a little subtle nudie color here and there. And then I went ahead to apply this on my nails right now. I did my nails in like sections, so I started off with like the first two fingers and I'll cure and then I'll do the last three fingers, just so it's a lot easier and I don't like overlap myself with like nail polish all over the place while making sure that everything is staying properly and nice. As you all can see, I'm only doing like one nail right now. My other nail, I haven't even taken off like the white polish I have on the other nail. This one nail alone takes me about an hour 30 minutes. So both nails, like both hands, what am I saying, both nails? Both finger, yay, one more English. Both hands takes me about 4 hours, I would say, for both hands. But right now I'm just starting off with like my left hand, which is currently what I'm using to show you guys how I achieved this entire nail look. I also did like two layers of this nail polish. So I did the first polish and then I cured for 60 seconds. And then right now I'm just repeating the entire process. Sometimes I go a little bit off with my nail polish, just like right now, so it smears on my skin. So normally I'll just clean that up right away before curing my nails in this UV lamp for 60 seconds. And then right now I just wanted to go ahead to do some little decoration here and there. I didn't really know what I was doing, to be honest, but I just wanted to, you know, play around a little bit. So I'll be playing around with my index finger, my middle finger, as well as my ring finger. And then for the rest of my other fingers, that's my thumb, as well as my pinky, just went ahead to apply my top coat right on those two and cure them. And then for this, you know, decoration, something, I got this butterflies from Amazon. I'm going to go ahead to use this gold one for my, my ring finger. And I'm going to go ahead to use the same builder gel that I used to, you know, build the entire nail. And I just use that to put these butterflies onto my nail, just to add a little bit of, you know, sparkle, glam on this nail. And I just tapped about four butterflies right there and went ahead to go over top of the entire layer of these butterflies with the same builder gel. And then I repeated the exact same process on my index finger as well with the same four gold butterflies. This entire set of butterflies comes with like different colors, so you can, you know, play around with some of them, have fun with it. And then for my middle finger, I just wanted to add like a little gold, is it gold or diamond, like these little studs. I don't know what they're called, but I placed some of the builder gel right there, like a spot of the builder gel, and I went ahead to put this gold stud right there and just stuck it down there. And right now I'm just repeating the entire butterfly process that I had on my ring finger, on my index finger, while making sure that I'm using my builder gel to actually keep this butterfly staying in place. And then after doing this entire builder gel covering up and everything, I went ahead to cure my nails again so I could dry down these three these three nails that we just did some spicy fancy stuff on. And this is what the nails currently look like. I'm just going to go ahead right now to use my nail file to clean up like the top, because like I said, this builder gel does move a lot. So in case your coffin shape just, you know, misplace itself, this is the time for you to, you know, make sure that the coffin shape is still perfectly there. You know, the shape of your nails is just there the way you would like it to be. You don't need to file too hard. You just clean up the little surface layer of builder gel that just messed around. Because if you file too hard, you'll be filing out the color, right? So you just want to do like a little soft, you know, low tension file on top of those nail. And then right now I'm just going to go ahead to finalize this entire process using my top coat to finish up everything. And I cured again for 60 seconds, and this was basically all I did, you guys. And then I use this nail polish remover to just clean off everything, just so I can see what I'm working with and make sure that there's no, you know, no smear, no stain, and none of that. And then I use this cuticle oil to just moisturize my nail beds and everything. And that is basically it for this video, you all. I hope this video was able to inspire you to, you know, to maybe save some money and just do your nails. And trust me, you can do it, okay? If I could do this, you can do it, and I believe in you. All right, I'll see you guys in my next video. I love you guys so much, and have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye.
What God has joined together, let no man put us under. Hey. Baby oh, baby oh, baby oh, I'll give you love and affection, I'll give you love and protection.